just got off Montezuma's Revenge and was fantastic. As good today as when I first rode it 30 years ago. Watch it catch it whizzing through here. That back row, you get a nice weightless second. It feels great. Throws you out of your seat a little bit. Looking forward to 2023. So sad to see it go. For now. Welcome everybody to another adventure with OG Coasters. And we are over by a different view of a place you'll probably recognize in a second. Boom, boom, boom. Knott's Berry Farm. My home park and the park where I rode my first roller coasters. Not counting family attractions at Disneyland. Then again, that might be debatable. Thunder Mountain could have been my first roller coaster. I'm gonna have to do some memory searching there, or bobsleds. But pretty sure it was that bad boy right there. Boomerang and Montezuma's Revenge. Yeah. We'll catch you guys inside. All dogs allowed.
Sorry, Spike, but I think I'll skip that. Cactus germs are even worse than dog germs.
World's largest dog treat.
Cheers for the winner of the fishing derby, Snoopy. I guess Snoopy decided to catch a prize fish instead of a nap today. Is there anything that dog can't do?
Here's the track for Jaguar.
Looks like his bird buddies bring the biggest and best boysenberry bushes to the beetle bonanza.
What was the boysenberry bushes, Mom?
That sentence and those boysenberries.
Jenny, that's where it started. That's where they grow the boysenberry bushes.
Bridge is the bandstand where Snoopy and the Daisy Hill family are playing some of their favorite songs. There are gangs here, so tap your toes and move your feet to the Bugle Bonanza Bluegrass Beat. What a great one for the day.
The Beagle Bonanza Band with Snoopy.
Scoutmaster Snoopy and the Beagle Scouts brought back some gourmet marshmallows from the Dairy Bonanza. They got strawberry, blueberry, and my favorite, Poison. I hope you save some for me. Well, campers, we're back in the camps with the Oompo. Thanks for riding with us. I hope you had as much fun as I did. See you next time.
Just got off Montezuma's Revenge and was fantastic. As good today as when I first rode it 30 years ago. Watch it catch it whizzing through here. That back row, you get a nice weightless second. It feels great. Throws you out of your seat a little bit. Looking forward to 2023. So sad to see it go. He told me that the refurbishment starts tomorrow, which is February 7th, 2022. So.
Once you are seated, roll the left bar towards you, and please remember to keep your hands and arms inside the car at all times.
Wait a minute. Forget Camp Snoopy. That's what we're focusing on. Montezuma's Revenge. Here it is, guys. The legend calls it a career tonight. Until it comes back in its next life. We are here at Knott's Berry Farm. It is 8:56 on Sunday, February 6th. One of the last trains ever. One of those things where you wish the ride could last.
The train is rapidly approaching the station. Please do not lean on or over the loading gate.
One of my last rides ever.
All personal devices are not permitted on this ride unless we decide to place it on airplane mode or watch it fly off the ride. Please make sure that we keep our hands and feet inside the car at all times. Thank you very much. We'll be on the next train. To my guests loading in, if the seats are tied down with a seatbelt, those seats are not available. Please choose one of our select seats with the lap bar fully extended up.
When the gates open, please step carefully into the car in front of you. Please place all loose articles, including hats, purses, packages, stuffed animals, and cameras, to your right, beyond in front of you. The train is rapidly approaching the station. Please do not lean on or over the loading gates.
Stand back from the gates, please.
I think this is a yell.
This is the final part. This is it. This is the Montezuma's Revenge going away party here for 2022, February 6th.
Beyond the yellow area. If you're wearing eyeglasses, please remove them and put them in a secure place such as a pocket or purse. Once you are seated, pull the lap bar toward you, and please remember to keep your hands and arms inside the
bar. The history, man.
At
this
all
is it.
Times.
Until the next one.
The yellow gates are closing. Step back, step clear.
Do you guys want this row and go ahead of us? Because we're probably going to wait one or two. I know everybody wants the ass kick row. So.
Thrilling one.
Well, yeah. Depending on your favorite, they're all good.
Yeah.
The front is different. In the front, you get farther up in the beginning, and you're more weightless an extra second going backwards. But in the back, you get thrown out of the seat more on that one. You get more airtime at the very end. Instead of 0 to 55 and 3, 3.5. So you have to take a breath, exhale. Dead logs. And then before you know it, you're 200 feet in the air. Then you breathe. And then it's over in about 20 seconds. It's pretty good.
She got on it. I haven't yet.
Yeah.
Is the next one the last one?
I think so.
Runners, please prepare for launch. Place your head against the headrest behind you and hold on to the handrail in front of you.
All clear. Dispatch.
I know what you mean.
Yeah.
Same here.
The
no, they're all going to get on it too. Yeah. What? I don't. I think so. I hope so. Right? They should let them know.
They get the last ride.
Well, I heard they were going to run in line before night. I don't think the staff got us. I don't know. I know they start the work tomorrow.
When the gates open, please step carefully into the car in front of you.
Well, play the Camp Snoopy music and let the lovely lady sing. We're gonna make it appropriate because that's all she wrote for Montezuma's Revenge. Oh, well, that's actually not Montezuma's Revenge, but you'll see it in a second. It was beautiful. It was a goodbye. I took screenshots of my emotional reactions. Gonna post up and add to the video. And seeing the joy in the employees' faces, they got the last public ride, the last private ride, all staff, but we got the last public ride. The staff here is so nice. They really were thoughtful to their guest. And that was four rides today, right? Four rides today. Four rides last time, last week. Six rides before that, two rides before that, 6, 4, 10, 14. So in 2022, we rode this at least 16, possibly 17 times, twice on New Year's. I think there's two more I didn't count. So 18 rides of Montezuma's Revenge in 2022. And this was the last night of Montezuma's Revenge ever. As I walk the bridge, a little more nostalgia. So 30 years ago to the date, you can do the math how old I am. Rode this at 8 years old for the first time. Montezuma's Revenge. Here I am in the Camp Snoopy Cave. Either Jenny's behind me or there's a goblin about to get me. Oh, hi, my love. And there it is. the last private ride ever. You can hear it. Can't see it, but you can hear it. I'm in the Camp Snoopy cave. You can hear the loop, the weightlessness. You hear the crowd. And you are hearing and seeing the very end. There's that little movement there of the very last train ever. You guys rock, Knott. Thank you for making a kid at heart's dreams come true. Last public train ever. Unbelievable. Considering there are 7 rows down out of 14. We did it. We did it. I chose Montezuma. Fantastic day here at the park, though. Rode Calco Rapids, still got a wet pocket, wet butt. It was worth it. Had a great ride on Jaguar. 4 rides on Montezuma, as we said. And got the Silver Bullet in. Calco Mine Train. Camp Snoopy Beagle Bonanza. Charles M. Schultz exhibit. Hey! Well, there's the last train. In all its glory. Well, a true moment of silence, because that was the swan song. That was the final trip on Montezuma, and its last ride was a ghost ride. A ghost rider, if you will. And, yeah. I'm okay with that cheesy pun to end this night. With the Linus and Lucy theme in the background. So, what a wonderful day at Knott's. Thank you all for joining me in my adventure. Talk about nostalgia. I always hope there'd be a Snoopy little raft ride where you go down like a little boat, canoe, and you go down a little drop. Like a mini log flume for kids. Good idea for Knott's, by the way. I wouldn't mind some royalties if you do that one day, but I've dreamed of that since I was little. So. Great day at the park. When I do have followers, I'll pretend I do, so I'll say thank you to you all. And, remember, it's not just about the video quality, it's about the story, and it's about the heart that I put into it. See, as I said, not about the video quality, no clarification, no filter. It was dark, you could barely see me. That's okay. This channel's about the heart. Sharing my love, my childhood love, that I fell back in love with a handful of years ago. I'll tell, which is roller coasters. She's the love of my life, but roller coasters are my side squeeze and my mistress. No, just kidding. All right. Beautiful night in Buena Park, 60 degrees. Hey guys, Matt here, and it's February 17th of 2024. To give you a little update, the Montezuma's Revenge restrooms have reopened. Montezuma's Revenge has not. Jaguar got a nice light package and a little refurb, but it's been a standstill here, 2 years and counting. We just passed the anniversary of Montezuma closing, so you're not going to see any cars going over this track. And there hasn't been a whole lot to report, guys. You figure out of an 800-something-foot track coaster, 860-foot track coaster, 600 feet of this track is straight. But somehow this refurbishment, you know, went at a standstill, and we all know about the issue with Coombat Coasters. You know, it's pretty much all but been confirmed about the lawsuit. And we're just waiting and hoping. The positivity from this channel only, guys. I know there's structural issues under the loop foundation now, so we're going to have to probably do a whole new foundation along with that, ordering the new parts for the loop and a new launch. But don't lose hope, guys, because we're still here and we're still hanging on for Montezuma's Revenge. You know, been riding it since 1990, so not going to give up on it anytime soon. So anyway, thank you for watching this presentation. If you did make it till the end, we will see you next time here. Appreciate all the support to the channel. And you guys take care and have a wonderful night. and we'll see you soon with hopefully good news. Once I get past their Camp Snoopy remodel, let's hope they'll stop playing Hear No Evil, See No Evil, Speak No Evil, and actually speak the name of Montezuma, the Forbidden Fortress, which now has been the forbidden topic. So until next time, guys, take care. This was Matt from OC Coasters and Theme Parks. And apologize for the horrible camera work in that video. That was before I'd ever started the channel. I just kind of filmed my emotional goodbye to Montezuma. Originally, it was personal, but I decided to share it. Take care and good night. Thank you all for the support on this journey, and we'll see you again soon.